On the eve of President Biden's climate summit with world leaders, the president is expected to make a big announcement to commit to slashing carbon emissions in half by the year 2030. And tonight, our series of reports, beginning with Ginger Z in the Mojave Desert, searching for what's called white gold, lithium used to power laptops, phones, and electric cars made in America. Could it help make a difference in fighting climate change and creating jobs in this country? Here's our chief meteorologist, Ginger Z.
Tonight, we go into the Mojave Desert searching for lithium, which could be the key to America's clean energy future. See, lithium powers our laptops, our phones, our electric vehicles. Esmeralda County, Nevada is the only place in the country commercially producing it.
Here at Silver Peak, they're not mining rock, they're farming lithium. These brilliant blue pools come from wells that tapped underground salt aquifers. Each of them, nearly 500 football fields long, are rich in lithium.
The sun evaporates the brine from the ponds, and that leaves lithium behind.
It's the lightest metal known to man. It's very energy dense. That reactivity in nature makes it hard to come by.
Does it have an agricultural or impact to the land surrounding?
We're not using water that would otherwise be used for an agricultural purpose.
There is an immense amount of lithium in the western U.S. and multiple ways to mine it. California, for example, could produce enough lithium to meet up to 40% of global demand. On the site of a proposed open pit lithium mine, a warning for the planet.
Lithium is extremely important to tackling the climate crisis. We need to start implementing environmental protections in the production of lithium.
And tonight, with U.S. automakers pouring billions into developing electric vehicles powered by those lithium batteries, researchers at UC Berkeley saying electrifying all new cars and trucks by 2035 could save consumers $2.7 trillion by 2050.
All this really interesting. Ginger's with us from Detroit tonight, home to our automakers. And Ginger, as you reported there, there seems to be a growing chorus of voices who see lithium production in the U.S. as a real opportunity to create jobs, as long as it's tackled, as that expert just said, very carefully.
Yes, there is no question, David, that an open pit lithium mine especially can be very difficult. Our environment, greenhouse gas emissions, toxic waste and more. Plus, when the batteries are not recycled properly, it's really bad for our planet. So we have to do better at that. But the U.S. automakers are committed to doing it. GM wants to be all electric by 2035, David.
All right, Ginger Z in Detroit tonight. Ginger, thank you for kicking off our series of reports. And by the way, you can watch more of Ginger's Earth Day reporting in a special report, It's Not Too Late, streaming on Hulu and tomorrow night on ABC News Live.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.